realize what it says.
Maybe I'll put a time. Oh! It's the end of the podcast now, but maybe you know what? I'm going to cut this and I'll put it in the beginning of the podcast. So welcome to the beginning of the podcast, people.
Oh my God,
I've been wanting to say
so
this
stupid.
For weeks, and I've been
you're dumb.
I've been fucking forgetting every time. So, in this podcast, any other topics we talk about,
like Karate Kid's asshole.
So this will also be the podcast twice because I'm putting it in the beginning and I'll leave it in the normal spot too.
Oh, that's
maybe
tricky.
I don't know. Maybe we'll figure it out. Anyways,
that's like an episode of Flash going back in time.
Anyways, any of the topics we talk about, I have time coded in the description. So, like, say you're like, I came here just to hear them talk about Logan. I don't give a shit about Flash. I don't give a shit about Supergirl.
Nobody gives a shit about Supergirl.
Taboo. Any of that shit. I just want to hear them talk about Logan. Say we talked about it 20 minutes in. You just go to the description, you just click on the 20 minutes in button, and then you're there to that part of the podcast. I've been meaning to tell people that so they can get to the certain topics they want to in the podcast.
I bet a lot of people already know that, though.
Maybe. If you look in the descriptions and all the videos you watch, then I guess you would know that.
Yeah.
But I feel like I should still tell people in case they don't. Now you know.
And what the fuck was that?
Should I call you Logan, Weapon X?
No, Wolverine, Snickety, Snickety, Snowing.
What he's doing is imitating Wolverine's berserker attack with his adamantium claws. All right, guys, you have your mission. Go forth.
What's up, Pleakers? Welcome back to the Pleaker Podcast. I'm Jerome.
And I'm Nick.
And today we'll be talking about this week's Flash, Supergirl, the finale of Taboo, and then at the end of the podcast we'll be talking about Logan, because we all went and saw that last week. And by all, I mean me and me and you.
Did you say last weekend?
I screwed the whole thing up. Whatever. Anyways.
We saw it last night.
Last night. Anyways, moving on, for fuck's sake.
We've been on for a second, and you're moving on. All
right,
cool.
That's not good if I start flubbing right in the beginning of the podcast.
Nope, not a good sign.
Anyways, might be an interesting one. All right, so we're skipping what we do this week, because mostly what we did this week was play video games, and then we went and saw Logan. So we're going to talk about Logan at the end, and then we're going to talk about video games and who will quote first this week. So okay. We're just going to go right into Supergirl. What did you think about Supergirl this week?
It was okay.
Yeah. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't a great episode.
To beat a dead horse, the sister annoyed the shit out of me again.
Yeah. Like I said last week, at least I believe I said last week on the podcast, I don't think I'm ever going to like her sister. Like, I don't think anything could happen to make me like her.
Yeah.
But I also don't think they're ever going to get rid of her.
And they don't use Martian Manhunter enough.
I did. We got to see him quite a bit this episode, which is
but
cool.
But then at the end, remember, didn't they go fight and then, like, he stayed back and watched?
Yeah.
It's like... Wait.
You know, I think they did an interview and they talked about why they do that a little bit. Mm-hmm. They said because he's so powerful that they don't like to use him a lot because he's overpowered. And they said he's basically like a green Superman sometimes. But I was like, well, sometimes you need that.
Yeah, does he have a kryptonite?
Not that I know of.
So then why the fuck would he stay
home? Yeah. He couldn't go on that planet because of the air or whatever, remember?
Okay, so if he doesn't go to that planet...
He's fine. He can fight.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, no, you go, Supergirl. It's all filled with kryptonite.
Them saying that bugs me a lot, because, like, they could use... If they used him, they used Mon-El, they used their super people to fight their battles. I mean, I know it's a show, and they got to, like, oh, it's got to take us a while to get this person, but, like, if you actually used your people, you'd be able to solve things a little bit. And, like, you can write other problems, like, why they can't beat the guy, but have them all fighting. Like, you introduce all these people on the show.
I mean, I don't know. It just seems like, in Flash, if there was someone, like, teaching him and who was faster and better and could do everything but stayed there and made him go do it...
Yeah.
It would be stupid.
See, that's why I like in Flash that, like... I mean, while he got powers, he actually went out and, like, fought with him. That's what I was saying before, that I liked that a lot.
Yeah.
It's because, like, instead of being like, oh, Wally, you got... Because they kind of did in the beginning. Oh, you got powers. No, but don't use them. And I was like, fuck Iris for that. But...
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, at any point, did you think the dad wasn't going to be?
No.
Yeah.
I figured he was going to be the whole time.
Yeah.
And Mon-El made some really good points on why he's like, I've been here like 3 months and I don't get to do shit. But he's been captured by our enemy for 15 years. And you guys just give him the keys to everything.
And they all got pissed at him for like saying, yeah, I really like Mon-El.
I do too. Which I don't know if it's everybody, but I know a lot of people online think he's annoying, just think he's an asshole. Which I don't really see why.
The asshole part, maybe, because he just kind of does whatever he wants.
Yeah, but you got to also, I know they're watching and they're seeing him think he's an asshole, but you got to think about it from his perspective. He's been on another planet his entire life. and comes here where everything's different.
Yeah.
A lot of things he does is going to seem like an asshole, but it's because he doesn't know any better.
Right.
And I'm pretty sure he was the prince of that land, so, like, he got whatever the fuck he wanted.
Right.
Yeah. Which I thought that was interesting when the dad threatened him. Like, oh, I know who you are.
Yeah. Like, I didn't get that. I didn't know who he was.
I'm assuming that.
Right.
It hasn't been confirmed. But, I mean, those people are coming after him. They showed that thing.
That's true. Why would they come after him if he wasn't somebody?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which they did. I don't know if this is a spoiler or not, but Kevin Smith did a Facebook Live, and their ship has landed on his Facebook Live. Because he showed them, like, they were building it and putting it together for the next scene they were filming.
Mm-hmm.
So I think his is, like, 18 or 19 episode. So it should be coming up soon where they land.
Yeah.
Like, I'd assume either before or after the musical episode with Flash.
I'm still not sure about that musical episode.
Yeah, that'll be weird. Yeah. Because, like, I get the bad guy's supposed to make him sing, but, like, I mean, I bet they'll make it really funny, too, but it's just going to be so weird hearing Flash sing and Cisco sing and all that, and, like...
Yeah.
But it could be really funny because it'll have scenes like that, and then it'll cut over to Martian Manhunter and Mono, and they're like, what the fuck is going on? Because they won't be singing.
Right.
Which is weird. I wonder why they're not affected by it.
Maybe because they're back there.
Well, no, they're going to be on Flash's episode, so, like...
I don't know.
They'll be... Because pictures with... There is Martian Manhunter, Mon-El, Kid Flash, and Cisco all in their suits together.
Oh, yeah.
Except they didn't show Mon-El in a suit, because, like, I guess they're not allowed to.
Uh-huh. But it's going to be so anticlimactic by the time it comes out.
I know. I just want him to be in a suit, right? Because I've mentioned it, like, oh, yeah, I'm building a suit, but whatever. He built Kara's suit in, like, two days in the first episode.
Same with... What's his name's? I just totally spaced his name.
Oh, Guardian?
Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah, Guardians wasn't even, like, oh, it's not finished. And he made a full metal suit, which he hasn't been in the show quite a bit. I'm thinking about it. He hasn't been in the past couple episodes.
I was going to mention that earlier. He wasn't even in last episode, was he?
Yeah. I thought I got a phone call for a second. My phone just vibrated randomly.
You were, like, so confused.
I was. But, yeah, he hasn't been in the past two episodes, which is weird.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I haven't missed him. I didn't even notice it, so I guess.
I noticed it, but... I mean, I don't know. He's not my favorite character. I really like, the guy that makes this
Wynn?
Suit? Yeah, I like him. I don't know.
I like
he's
him
growing
too.
On me.
And I don't know the guy's exact name, which I'll put a picture of him up here for the video podcast, but the guy from iZombie is going to be joining the show pretty soon.
Oh, yeah, you told me that, but I don't know who he is.
Which I really like him. I can see you liking him in iZombie. He's, like, he's just, like, the funny guy. He works with her. He's the first guy that figured out she was a zombie.
Oh.
He's kind of like the Cisco, he's like a scientist and, like, makes stuff for her, stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
But he's supposed to be a scientist coming on to Supergirl and, like, showing them all kinds of stuff at Catco, but then he's supposed to have, like, a history with Lena Luthor.
Oh, that's right.
So I wonder if that'll be how he's going to be a villain, because they said he could be a potential villain in the future.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so that'd be kind of neat. Because if we got a recurring villain, kind of like Captain Cold and Flash, that'd be kind of neat.
He's not really reoccurring anymore, is he?
He's supposed to be. He's supposed to be on every show. He has a contract for every show, and he's showed up on two of them once this season.
How does that make you feel?
And then what's really annoying, too, is I follow Heatwave on Instagram.
Uh-huh.
Which that's not his real name. But
no, it's not?
No, it's Dominic Purcell.
I thought it was Heatwave.
But he keeps showing behind-the-scenes pictures because they just finished filming, and Captain Cold's on set, so I know it's coming soon. But I'm like, motherfucker, every episode I'm waiting, like, no, he didn't show up that episode. And, like, they'll, like, make little hints, and I'll be like, oh, is he going to show up? Like, in the trailer for next
episode. Really go,
yeah, the trailer for next episode, they did something, and it said Captain, and I was like, Cold? And then it was something about Captain Rip Hunter, and I was like, oh, fuck you. I want Captain Cold. Like, you know they put that in there, so people are like, Captain?
Captain?
God. All right, you want to move over to Flash? I don't really got anything else to say about Supergirl.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, I'm only watching Supergirl because it's connected to Flash.
Yeah.
In a very vague way.
Yeah.
Because they'll have their third crossover later, like, soon.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's kind of connected. They're, like, buddies.
I really want to... Because, like, I watched Arrow this week, and I was like, God, I love the show. I could watch this. I could watch just this episode over and over again this week of Arrow.
That's what I would have talked about if we talked about what we're doing. I watched quite a
bit. Oh, you should mention a little bit.
No, it's fine.
We'll pause real quick, just because you're catching up on season one of Arrow. How do you feel about Arrow so far?
Oh, I mean, I've liked it.
You
from
like
the, from the beginning, which is funny because everyone tells me that season one is, like, slow.
It was just the first four episodes, which especially when, like...
I never felt that way.
I didn't watch any of the other shows at that point, so I was like, oh, God, I don't, like,
the
it's
only,
weird.
The only problem is sometimes I just want things to get going because...
Oh, yeah, I can see that.
But, like... I think one of my favorite characters is Felicity.
Yeah, I like her a lot.
So, like, now she's in it. Like that comment when we just watched.
Yeah, what do you do? Kick his dog?
Yeah, like, that's funny. She's funny, so.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, so I'll be caught up soon enough.
Yeah, I'm hoping you're caught by next season because then we could talk about it on here.
I will be. Just relax. Like,
I really want to talk about this week's Arrow. It was just so good, and they revealed the bad guy and all this stuff.
And you can start talking about it?
Well, no, who am I going to talk to it about? Fucking an Arrow pop figure? Can you believe that happened, Oliver? And then I'll make him move and talk back to me.
I could totally see you saying that.
Yeah, it's not going to happen. All right, but so you like Arrow?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So Flash.
Flash.
Part 2 of Attack on Gorilla City. Not silly. Attack on Gorilla City.
Gorilla City.
And this one was called the Attack on Central City. What do you think about it?
I mean, it was good. It was cool. There was, I didn't know how they were going to beat him. I thought they were good. Like, because you told me they were going to get the Flash from 19. I mean, you told me he was going to show up. You didn't
yeah.
You
had doubted me in the last podcast, by the way. I just want to point that out, that I was correct and that he did show up.
Fucking with you.
Yeah, but if he didn't show up, you wouldn't have been fucking with me. And it'd be all about how I was stupid.
Well, just because he showed up doesn't beat you not stupid.
All right, whatever. Move on. What were you going to say?
But, he was in it for a second. He was in it for a Flash.
He wasn't. Did you notice his lightning was blue when he ran away?
No.
Or like blue or white?
No. Blue or white?
Which one was it?
It
was like a bluey white.
You're a bluey
white. And he was like a Flash. How was I supposed to know exactly what color it is?
He was literally in it for a second. That was a little retarded.
But I think because they put that in there, he's going to come back later.
And I never believed, what's the girl's name that has the vibe powers?
Vixen? No, not Vixen. That's the other show. fuck, now I forgot her name.
Whatever.
You keep talking. I'm going to look her up.
All right, I never thought for a moment that she wasn't going to help, but I didn't think she was going to bring back that other gorilla.
What's funny, in the beginning, I was thinking, well, why don't they just go get the other gorilla? And
you never said that.
Well, I said it. Oh, I would have said I said out loud. But I was like, why don't they just go get the other gorilla and fight, and that'd make things a lot easier. And then as the episode went on, I was like, oh, well, I guess I'm not going to do that. So then once that happened, I was really surprised because I was like, oh, they are going to get him. That's cool. And then they got to see the gorillas fight.
Yeah, which was kind of cool.
Alright.
So I mean, it's different. It's something, like, out of the ordinary that you get to watch.
I was a little disappointed because, like, the first part was really cool. You got to see a ton of girls and all that stuff, and I felt like this was kind of, like, a little slow. Like, but it was a little more of a normal Flash episode than, like, a two-parter, you know?
Yeah.
So her name, Gypsy. That's what it is. But overall, it reminds
me of Snatch.
Why? Is there a character named Gypsy in Snatch?
They're all gypsies. That's what Snatch. That's what Brad Pitt.
I don't know. I don't watch Snatch. Okay.
Jesus.
I'm
ashamed of you.
I really liked the two Harrison Wells talking to each other the whole time. Like,
when he's spitting his coffee.
Yeah, spitting his coffee and like, all that shit. That was hilarious. They had Friends Day going on, so HR kept giving everybody Friends Day stuff.
And then when he told Wally that he was sick and dying, I'm like, I don't believe that shit.
When it happened, I was like, oh, is that how they're gonna get rid of this Harrison Wells? Is like he's just gonna die?
Yeah, and I said, I don't believe it.
And that's funny, because she talked, usually, I expected Jesse to be like, oh, my dad's dying, go talk. And he's like, oh, no, I was lying. But then the second Wally tells her, she's like, he told you that, really?
Yeah.
And she gets up and goes yell at him. And then it's funny, after all that, she leaves the room, and Cisco goes, all right, dead man, how's this work?
Yeah.
It was a really funny episode.
Yeah, well, it's kind of cool that they can bring people from another Earth, which sounds fucking retarded, and then you actually care about the characters.
Yeah.
And they're different. Like, we really believe that there's two
HRs there. Talking to each other.
Yeah.
I forget who it was. Someone I followed tweeted out that they're waiting for the Orphan Black episode of Flash, where there's just a whole episode of only all different types of HRs talking to each other.
Oh, my God.
Which I would totally watch that.
Yeah, that would be exciting.
That, like, I wonder how many different characters that fucking fly, get out of here. There's a fly buzzing around us. How many different characters Harrison Wells could be, like, how many he could pull off.
See, the first one and the second one are very similar. The one's more of a dick,
yeah,
but they're very similar. But this third one's fucking goofy as fuck.
Yeah. I mean, they're similar, but they're also odd. Because, like, the other one was, like, more of a, like, I feel like HR can have more fun. Harrison Wells.
Yeah.
Could have more fun than Harrison Wells, the original one. And, like,
right.
Like, I feel like he cares about his daughter. Like, there is some differences, but they are because they're the most similar, though.
He was really the Reverse Flash, so who knows how.
Yeah, but I get you what you're saying.
And I guess, technically there is four Harrison Wells because there was that original one that with his wife and all that. So do you think if Reverse Flash wouldn't have killed Harrison Wells at the beginning, took over his body, and killed his wife in that accident, that there'd be a Jesse Quick on this? I mean, she doesn't have to have speed powers. I don't know her last... I guess Jesse Wells. Do you think she would exist, Earth 1? Because you think of, because of all the events in Season 1, Earth 1 Jesse can't exist. Like, he killed her.
I cannot think about that.
But isn't that kind of, I just thought about that right now. Isn't that weird?
No, I'm not going
to
think about it.
Like, he stopped her from existing because he wanted to kill Barry. And, like, he needed that to happen quicker.
Yeah, but...
I mean, it's not like he knew that was happening, but, like... Because I'm assuming...
But, like, you could go down the line.
Yeah. You could do infinite things. I also want to bring up, before I forget, so, Barry proposed to Iris.
Yes.
So, and we had this theory on the show, which I still think, Savitar could be somebody. I'll probably be very disappointed. He's just some random fuck.
What if?
Kind of like another show I watched, where it was just some random fuck, and they said it was a Season 1 character.
What if he's a Beastie Boy?
Shut the fuck up. Anyways, so we have this theory that, and not necessarily that it's Eddie, even though I would love it if it was Eddie, but that Eddie is the cause of, because he's showing up in an episode coming up soon, that you had this theory that you said when you were going for a walk a previous theory, that they stop Eddie from killing himself, which changes the future, them doing that makes Eddie and Iris together because they never broke up because he never died.
Right.
So I was thinking another way to make Flash even more sad because he always has to be sad.
And have her propose to her.
He proposes to her. They're about to get married. They stop that from happening. Now she's with Eddie.
And he would be the only one who knows.
He'd be the only one that knows that, me and Iris are going to get married. He'll be all sad about it. Everyone's like, what's wrong, Barry? And he'd be like, nothing. And then they're like, we changed the timeline again.
Yeah.
Because this season's all about changing the timeline. And either Eddie becomes Savitar, and then Season 4, they can get back together.
It'd be kind of funny if that's what happened.
Because, like, they can redo their relationship Season 4, and they could just prolong them getting married because of that, too, if Eddie became Savitar. Because he said Flash created him, so that would make sense.
But wouldn't him not dying uncreate him?
No, because what I'm saying is them making him not die does create him.
Oh.
Or that event could just cause something that creates him. I don't know. We're just kind of throwing those two together.
Yeah.
But I think that'd be cool. And I think I feel like if they were going to do that, that's what they would do because they need Flash to be sad.
They do need Flash to be sad.
Like, if a couple episodes go by and he's not sad, something bad's going to happen soon.
The first season, he was sad about his mom and his dad.
And then the next season, he was real sad about his dad.
Yeah. And his mom.
Yeah.
So, I mean, he's been way too happy this episode. Or this season.
Yeah.
Even though something bad has to happen soon. Even though he saw Iris die, it's not real because it was in the future. So he's not really sad about it.
But he knows it's still a possibility.
Right. But he's not mourning over
it. And the way things are going, like...
And I don't think they'll kill Iris.
Oh, we stopped something. Oh, no. It just happened a different way. Oh, we stopped the gorillas. Oh, no. We caused the gorilla attack to happen. So, like,
at some point, can't they figure that out? And they're just going to have to roll the punches.
Yeah.
Or go back in time and save Eddie.
I'm hoping that's what happens. I'm really hoping that's what they do.
What if they go back in time to 1955? And then
they meet Marty McFly's parents. And then they go to the enchantment under the sea dance. And they end up making that song.
But then they kill Marty McFly's mom.
Oh my God.
Or the Reverse Flash does.
And then Marty becomes the Flash?
Yeah.
Now that's a good movie.
There you go.
I like that. Connect Back to the Future and Flash. I would totally watch that.
You'd be the only one.
No, I wouldn't. Can you imagine people that love Flash and love Back to the Future? You put those together? That'd be amazing.
Flash to the Future.
Yeah, you know, I'm...
Oh, my God.
No, remember, I think it was, like, the first thumbnail we did for this, for the Flash, when we started adding Flash to this podcast. I think I had the DeLorean out there, but it was Barry Allen standing next to it for the Flash and all that.
Oh, really?
It was either this or it was when me and Taylor did it on I'm a Goldfish. I'll find the picture and I'll put it up here. I'm pretty sure we did that. That just jogged my memory.
I was just yapping.
So what'd you think about the end twist, kind of, when Wally went to go get Jesse Big Belly Burger, because she's too lazy to get off her ass and go get it herself. It,
first of all, she's a fucking speedster. If she wants to get some fucking hamburgers, can't she go get them?
I could use some Big Belly Burger. And he's like, fine, I'll fucking do it. And runs out the door.
He did not say fucking.
He wanted to. He's like, you fucking lazy bitch. And runs out the door. He's like, I'm trying to watch a movie. You turn off my movie.
Which she didn't even like. And then she makes him go get it?
Yeah. She's a bad girlfriend. Anyways.
Typical bitch.
And then she gets him attacked by Savitar. And then
and then he was like, Savitar. No. So.
Were you going to sing that one Ozzy Osbourne song?
No. I'm a little hoarse. So.
When you do that, if I remember in editing, I'm going to turn you into a little horse.
Like a My Little Pony.
Oh, that'll be the funniest thing ever.
Oh, my God.
All right. So, what are you saying, you little horse?
You're dumb. What was I saying? Oh, so he runs out, and you could see it coming a mile away.
I was thinking about you being a little horse, and then you said he's running out, and I imagined him as a horse running. Anyways, yeah, so Savitar came attacking him.
Are you done yet?
Yeah, I'm done.
Fucking retard. Yeah, I mean, I don't. It was pretty obvious that, like, it was because it was weird. Like you thought the show was over, and then you're like, oh, okay, something bad.
Yeah, something's gonna happen.
So maybe he'd get hit by a bus or something.
He's a speedster. He can just dodge it. You don't think he could dodge a bus?
No.
Oh.
What if he wasn't looking?
But in the trailer for Next Dawn, Barry says that, oh, he's just in your head and all that. But then they show
him. He's not in his head.
But then they show him like, oh, I finally got what I needed. And he like looks like he's crawling out of the Speed Force.
Is that
like
your Savitar voice?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's crawling out of the Speed Force right in front of Barry. So like, you think he escapes the Speed
Force? Why does he look like a Transformer?
I don't know.
Doesn't he?
Yeah.
Like, I expect Mark Wahlberg to try to shoot him.
Especially because, like, that's not at all what he looks like in the comics. He's a shirtless guy with, like, pants on and, like, some weird fucking hair. So, like, I don't know why they just didn't. I mean, I guess because. See, that's my thing, too. They could have just used a shirtless guy.
Like, any shirtless guy?
Blonde hair, just like Eddie.
I don't want to see Eddie shirtless.
Mom, a lot of people might. But anyways, what I'm saying is if they could have just used. If it's going to be a normal guy, why not just dress him up like his normal comic character? But no, you're hiding his face. So you can pick who you want it to be.
Or you want him to change into a car and drive away. What if he changes into the DeLorean?
That would be cool, but that would also be very stupid. It can't be. But don't you get what I'm saying, though? Like, if it's just an average show, why not just make it, like, save your money on CGI, just dress him up like the comic book character?
What do you care how much money they spend?
Well, what I'm saying is, like.
You just want more Grodd episodes?
I mean, if it'll be cool episodes, yeah. But you get what I'm saying, though. Like, if it's going to be
a show,
just save your money.
I don't know if I agree with what you're saying, but I get what you're saying.
Oh,
yeah.
So now you don't agree with me.
Well, I don't usually agree with you.
Yeah, no, because you know what you are? A little horse.
Oh, my God, you're fucking retarded.
This episode might be called Nick's a Little Horse.
Let me clear my throat there.
Can you neigh for me?
Nope.
You should have said that. That's going to be stuck in my head the rest of your life.
You're so stupid. At least you get over it quick. You only giggle for like 10 minutes.
All right. So is that all you want to talk about, Flash?
Let's talk about little horses.
Okay. This week on My Little Pony.
What about your little pony?
Well, you don't want to talk about little horses. But you want to move over to the finale of Taboo?
No.
Yeah. Okay. Should skip that.
We could do that.
So how did you feel about the finale?
It was pretty good. I didn't think it was great.
Yeah, I didn't get any answers.
The show itself was great.
I do have to say, though, remember first episode of this podcast we did about Taboo?
Oh, if he asked.
And I said by the end of the season he'll die and then come back to life.
Did you say that?
That didn't happen. I told you, I said, I bet you like $5.
Oh, didn't you say like you thought he was dead already or something?
I said, I think he's dead before he will die. I mean, his sister died, so maybe that counts.
No, that doesn't count.
He made out with his sister underwater and he wasn't really there.
That doesn't mean you're dead.
She's dead.
Who cares?
He fucked his dead sister.
She was annoying anyway.
You know, that's a good. You know how to sell a show? Tom Hardy fucks his dead sister. How do you not watch it just because of that?
He did not fuck his dead sister. He fucked his sister, and now she's dead.
Well, yeah, but they were underwater making out.
That's not fucking.
But they might not have showed us everything. They have to cut some scenes out.
Shut the fuck up. You're stupid. Did you see the way she jumped off the bridge?
Yeah, it was like she was swan diving into a pool.
Yeah, I didn't get it. Like, her arms were all flailing.
Which, I mean, she died, but that seemed like a little tiny jump.
It was a bridge.
Well, yeah, but I've seen Steve-O jump off of plenty of bridges. And
she's not fucking Steve-O.
Why not? She's fucking her brother. But, like, I've seen him jump off
not of anymore.
Plenty of bridges, and he's alive.
Well, and she's not.
I've seen him jump farther distances than
maybe
she
didn't know how to swim.
Maybe she hit her head. No, I guess there's no rocks in there. I don't know.
There's rocks at the bottom. I just didn't see the bottom.
I just don't get why she died. It wasn't that big of a jump. I think she's a pussy.
Well, she might be a pussy, but what if she didn't know how to swim?
No, I guess, yeah, she could just...
I said that like 5 minutes ago.
Well, then why not just drown herself in a bathtub?
It's not as dramatic.
I guess you don't really have to swim to be in a bathtub.
Plus, he's got that thing with the water. I don't know. I think that's what she was going
for. So why don't you think he felt it when she died? Or was she just sitting there, like,
maybe
drowning?
He's too busy getting the shit beat out of him.
Maybe. Imagine what his leg looks like now, because he got, like, cheese grated.
Like a quesadilla?
Yeah. They probably had a Tom Hardy.
No, I mean, that's what his leg looks like.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, they took his skin and made a quesadilla.
So I did like the fact that that old guy from Game of Thrones, the priest, what was his name? I can't remember.
We just kept calling him Old Fuck.
I liked the fact that he blew up at the end. That was cool.
Yeah, I liked that. I didn't think, and then I almost felt bad for that black guy because I was like, he kind of used him, and like, I mean, he used a lot of people. But that black
guy used every single
person.
That black guy
wasn't bad though, and like, but then at the end, he gave him what he wanted,
even though he killed the guy.
I mean, maybe he's just gonna take down the whole company.
But they're all dead, aren't they? Weren't they in that building?
Most of them are. If they didn't die in that explosion, they got shot in the head by Tom Hardy's
people.
And
I like the fact that the skinny annoying guy and the fat annoying guy
got shot in the head.
Yeah, I don't know their names. I'm glad they got shot.
And his little chemist guy got fucked too.
His little who?
His little chemist dude.
Oh yeah, he was fucked up.
His face is all blown up.
What did you say when you saw him all burnt up?
Yeah, burnt.
Every fucking time.
Yeah. So
and you don't even watch Seth Meyers. That's the part that
I watched the burnt parts and everything else. You show me at least one thing per episode that he's done.
Well, that's not true. Okay. I usually skip an episode or two.
Anyways, I was a little. I didn't see that it was going to be the American as the leaky boat guy.
What?
He said there's a leak in your boat and he was going to fix it. I thought he was talking about the girl's like facility she was running. Because, you know, he killed the American guy.
Yeah.
I thought he was talking about the girls. People.
The girl said it to the other spy girl.
Well, I know
she said there's a leak in your boat.
Yeah, I know, but I thought it was like I didn't think it like it was anybody to do with Tom Tart. I thought it was just some random person that they were gonna fix it.
I just assumed it was.
So when you said that, I was like, oh, that totally makes sense. Yeah, I'm stupid.
Plus he was a little smartass about it too.
Yeah,
he was a little smartass from the beginning. I like that guy.
He kind of always is and stuff like a little bit.
He wasn't in House of Cards, but I only watched the first couple seasons.
Oh, see, I thought he was, but maybe not. And like, I know he is in Man of Steel a little bit.
Oh, is he?
Because he works at the Daily Planet there.
In House of Cards, he was pretty fucking serious.
Oh, really?
Yeah. At least in the seasons that I watched.
But I kind of liked, like, after Tom Hardy killed him, he put him in all the paint. Yeah. Like, kind of make him look like an American flag and put him up there.
I thought it was funny he dunks his head in the blue paint, and then he, like, just, like, totally loses it. And that's when he started making out with his sister.
Yeah.
And then it's, you still got his head in pain.
Like, whatever. I mean, it's not like he's going anywhere. He's dead.
Yeah, I guess. Well, he wasn't, was he dead at that point?
I think so, wasn't he?
He just bashed his head on a
desk. Didn't he pour that poison in his mouth?
That wasn't poison, it was lot.
It was what? A little horse?
I can't say the word. Same shit they take in Tombstone.
I've never seen that.
It's a painkiller.
So he made him overdose. So I guess, yeah, he didn't die yet.
Yeah. Well, maybe he drowned in blue paint.
And
then all of Tom Hardy's people got fucked up, except for him.
Most of them, yeah. Everybody got shot at least once, and that one dude from Snatch got, like, cut in the arm and shit.
In the face.
It was the face, too?
Yeah. His face is all bloody.
So there is going to be a season 2, according to Tom Hardy. Which I believe, because they stopped calling it a limited miniseries, even when the show was starting.
Which I never noticed.
All the trailers before said limited series and all the shit, and then the last episode they said, oh, the season finale, and I was like, season finale?
Right.
Normally it's series finale, and then at the end it just said...
I mean, I believe you. I just didn't season.
So then I looked it up, and Tom Hardy is going to be season 2.
I don't know how that's going to work.
It'll just be them in the boat, I guess.
Well, that does not sound fun.
You know why? Because they'll be all pirates, a hard medium, Tom Hardy, hard. That'll be them.
Please don't ever do that again.
That'll be the whole season too. Tom Hardy as a pirate.
No, see, that's stupid.
I bet it'll be halfway through the journey. I bet it'll be a 3-season thing. He goes halfway through there, and then season 3, he's getting to America.
You think it could take him a fucking season to get to America?
I mean, it's only 8 episodes.
Well, fuck, I don't want to see 8 episodes of him on a boat.
No, it won't be. I think he'll, like, keep landing places, because, like, I bet you season
two... Where are you going
to
land?
Season 2 is them getting to his little...
I mean, I know...
His African place. And then...
They're not going to Africa.
Well, he said he's going to his mother's land. So where... Yeah, he's going to his land that he owns, where his mother's at or whatever.
That's fucking, like, Canada or Washington.
Well, I didn't know the name of his actual islands.
Well, it's not Africa. It's the opposite fucking direction.
Whatever. This isn't geography.
Thank God, because you would have gotten an F.
Whatever. So I think he'll be getting to there, and there'll be probably like a few episodes there, and then the following season will be him in America. I bet you that's the plan.
Yeah, I guess. He's going to have to find more dead people. Is that how he knows everything's going on, because the dead people tell him what's going on?
I think so, yeah. I think they kind of answered that.
I mean, because he doesn't know anybody in America. I do like it when he goes... He goes, we got the gunpowder for the Americans. And he goes, we are Americans. And they both kind of like smiled.
And I was like, you don't sound like Americans.
Yeah.
I mean, they did put up American flags. I guess they're just going to pretend to be Americans now.
Well, they're Americans.
But I was thinking too. So
thank God Trump's not there. He would have stopped them.
The king sent all those fuckers after Tom Hardy. Not one of them thought, hey, let's get on a boat.
That king.
Like one ugly motherfucker.
And then, like, he was getting his portrait done, and I'm like, if I look like that, I'm not getting my portrait.
But isn't that the time where, like, if you're fat, you're known to be wealthy? Because, like, you're actually getting food?
Maybe.
I know at some point in England, like, the fatter you are, the more wealthy you are. And, like,
he's got a lot of money.
Yeah. Well, he's the king.
He looked like he was pregnant, because he was, like, fat and
weird.
It's
funny, because, like, the first, like, 4 or 5 episodes, I didn't recognize him. And then I was like, wait, that guy's in, like, Doctor Who, and he's in, Sherlock and all that shit.
I didn't know who the fuck
he was. He's a writer for a lot of stuff in Doctor Who also. And I was like, oh, that's him?
He no wonder I didn't like
so
him.
Disgusting in this. Like, he just looks so different.
I mean, he was supposed to look disgusting, but it was just like...
Yeah.
A little over the top.
I wonder if that's like accurate to what the king looked like in that time.
I have no idea.
I guess I could look it up, but I don't want to right now.
Yeah. And I don't want you to either.
So what are your final thoughts on Taboo? And what are you looking forward to and hope that's in season 2?
I have no expectations for season 2. I know he said there'll be a season 2. I just don't know. I would watch it because Tom Hardy was cool in this. Mm-hmm. I just don't know where it would go.
I mean, also, if it's in England, they could take their time, because usually, like, English shows can go, like,
yeah, like,
they had one season, they could have another one in 2 years if they wanted, like, you know what I mean?
Right. That never sounds like a good idea to me. I mean, like, yeah, Westworld. Well, like, we'll see you in, like, 3 years. Like, yeah. Right, fuck off.
Like, I bet season... I mean, everybody's going to watch Westworld, but I bet a lot of people won't, because it takes so long that they'll just lose interest. Because people lost interest by the season finale, which I don't know how. It only got better for me, but, like...
Right. I don't know. Like overall, what would you give this? I'd give it, like, either an A- or B+. I don't know why I went with letters, but I did.
Yeah, I was going to go with numbers. I think I give it an A-. Like... every episode is enjoyable, some more than others, but I think overall, I'd definitely say watch the series.
I think it's
not my favorite series of the year.
Really? It's like the only series we watched this year, 2017.
Didn't Westworld end this year?
It ended last year, 16.
Well, I'm counting that still this year.
Oh, all right. I didn't know you had your own calendar.
Yeah, I have a drum calendar. You know, but like just said,
I'm just fucking with you.
Not my favorite series I've seen in a while.
There was times that this was...
like, really, really good.
Really good. The last episode didn't really do a whole lot for me. It wasn't bad.
Yeah.
I didn't think it was bad. I wanted...
To me, it seemed like a lot of, like...
I wanted...
Just ending certain things that were going on in the season, and then, like, a setup for next season, because now they're on the boat going out.
Like, you know when the... I wanted that little fucking guy that talked to the king. I wanted him to die, too, because he was a little fucking bitch.
I did like, though, every time, like, he looked, like, so awkward, like, walking in there, like... We have to let Mr. Delaney go.
Yeah.
Like, every 5 minutes, he kept having to walk in there and do stuff.
Well, and, like, when they were interviewing him, and he's like, if I'm going to crush your balls, and he's, like, saying all this stuff, and he's like, you said you'd give me a name, and he, like, just looks up and goes, I guess I lied.
Yeah.
I wanted him to, like, get out of the cuffs and, like, just kill everybody.
Yeah, so did I, but, like...
But, I mean, you don't get everything you want, obviously.
Yeah.
But
I feel like...
Which then...
I feel like he would have if he didn't have already have a plan to get out of there and all
well,
that.
Well, yeah, and then it'd be kind of hard to explain that, you know, that he's leaving now.
Yeah.
You know, so... Because he walked out on his own 2 feet.
Yeah.
Because they didn't press charges.
Which I was surprised they didn't drag that out more. Like, it was like, oh, he's out. Okay, boom, he's out. Like, usually, like, oh, he's out. You got to wait for all shit to happen. I thought it'd be like, And then the very end moments would be him, like, getting to his boat.
Yeah, but no one, yeah. Yeah, I know what you're saying, but, like, no one else knew what to do except
yeah.
They just did whatever he told, whatever their little note said.
It's true.
He's definitely had everything planned out.
I like that, too, because he's always the smartest guy in the room, but never looks like it and never acts like it.
Never acts like it.
Yeah, like...
The one guy's like, I always got that last ace, and then his last ace was the guy that he was going to kill.
Yeah.
Like, that didn't work out for him very well.
But yeah, overall, I did really like the show.
I'd give Tom Hardy, like, an A+ for...
Yeah, Tom Hardy is the best thing about the show.
Yeah. I mean, without question, he was just, like... You just want to watch to see what else he's going to fucking do.
Yeah.
He's like, even when he was crying about his sister, you're like, oh, he's crying. Oh.
Yeah, it was like, it was actually weird seeing him sad. And like, he actually tried to, like, kind of hide it from that girl, too.
Yeah.
It's weird because, like, I think threw him off because, like, he knows everything. And then he's like, oh, wait, that happened? That wasn't supposed to happen.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, it's kind of partly his fault, too, for getting a relationship with her. And then, like...
And then telling her to fuck off.
And then they never explained who talked to her and told her to kill her husband. Which, I mean, they can't now because she's dead and that she comes back and talks to him as a ghost.
Which is what
she'll
she
be,
was doing.
She'll be like Mike Franks in NCIS.
Oh, for fuck's
keeps
sake.
Coming back to him as a ghost.
Didn't they Mike or Frank?
That was the most... So, we watched NCIS, and the character Mike Frank shows up. And when he gets there...
And he'd show up, like, once every couple episodes. It's not like he's on there all the time.
Yeah.
It'd be, like, six episodes
in the beginning,
later.
It'd be, like, oh, maybe once or twice a season he'd be there. So, he shows up, and we're like, what's his name? And you're like, I think it's Mike. And I was like, I don't know. It might be Frank. I feel like his name's Frank. And then, like, it was during the commercial. And then the show comes back and walks up to him and goes, hey, Mike Franks. And we're like, oh, son of a bitch. And we couldn't stop laughing because
yeah,
we're like,
that was funny.
We both had half his name.
Yeah.
That was back when we used to watch NCIS.
Yeah, I'm kind of glad we don't anymore.
Me too. Well, especially, like, everything else we watch now would be kind of hectic. Like, especially watching two NCISs and all the other
I wouldn't mind still watching LA, but I don't want to watch NCIS.
Didn't they kill off Kenzie on that show in L.A.?
They were getting close.
Well,
because,
like, I saw a trailer for it when we were at Mima's house, and I didn't see her anywhere in the trailer. I mean, they could have just not had her in that episode, but I remember Mima talked about that a while ago, and I didn't see her around.
Yeah, I don't
and
know.
That one dude actually died in real life, and they killed him in the show, so.
My Fitbit just told me to walk.
Did you tell it to fuck off?
Basically.
Vance, do you want to move over to Logan? Now we talked about a ton of taboo.
No. Let's talk about
sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Talk about dads and... I almost said husbands.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, I thought you were going to sing that. So, where does Logan stand on your comic book movie scale?
Like, what do you mean?
Like, what would you... Like, how much did you like it, basically?
Why don't you just ask me that?
Well, I don't know.
It weighed about 10 pounds. Is that
I didn't
kind of
ask how much it weighed.
Oh, I think
I said, where does it stand?
No, I liked it a lot. I thought it was really, really cool.
You know, I was going to put out a poll, and I completely forgot to. I was going to have everybody vote what was their favorite, like, Wolverine movie, and then I was going to pull it up here on the podcast.
Problem is, it just came out.
Well, I was going to put it out last night, because everybody that, like, cares would have voted last night, and, like, it kept going today, and then I completely forgot. Didn't do it.
People would have voted for the new one, even though they haven't seen it.
Yeah, probably. But I was going to put this, the new one, I was going to put Wolverine.
Okay, so here's
the
first problem.
One.
I've seen the first X-Men.
Yeah.
And I saw the Wolverine movie
with Deadpool in it, Ryan
Deadpool.
Reynolds?
Ryan Reynolds.
Did you like the first X-Men you saw, like, originally?
Yeah, it was okay. I liked it.
I remember I saw those when I was really little. Yeah. But I just recently watched them because I bought the whole pack on Blu-ray. Hold on, I think the mailman's here again. Always interrupting our podcast.
There's no one here.
Yeah, there's no one. They're barking for no reason. Anyways, but I, like, just watched those, and I actually like them. Like, they are a little dated, and they seem kind of old. And, like, the first one, Hugh Jackman is so tiny.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. But I do like them. Like, they're not as bad as I've heard people talk about.
No, I didn't.
No, the X-Men Origins Wolverine.
That's the one I was talking about. That was one of the worst movies I've ever seen.
Yeah. Ryan Reynolds and Hugh Jackman are good in it, but, like, the story overall is really, really shitty and stupid. And, like, they ruined Deadpool. And
yeah.
Can you imagine if they did Deadpool right then, how, like, great the stuff would be now with Deadpool? Or do you think it's better that they fucked him up because
I think
it came
it's better
out now?
The way it worked out. Yeah.
Yeah. Probably. That's probably right.
Can I yell at them?
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up!
You scared my bunny. She was like, oh, fuck! Nick's yelling!
Shut the fuck up, too.
And she's not making any noise. Leave her alone.
She's thinking about it.
Probably. continue what you were saying about the X-Men movies.
So I saw the first X-Men movie and liked it. But not enough to care to watch the rest of them.
Mm-hmm.
X-Men a little too weird for me.
Why?
Well, I mean, think about their abilities.
Yeah, but I guess they have more abilities than, like,
Avengers. They're weird. I don't know.
Okay, so you're part of the, like, in their world, you'd be part of the problem. Like, fuck these mutants.
Yeah.
What if there was a mutant there that could, like, use the air and wipe your ass?
Wait,
like he can.
Why would they go like this?
I don't know.
What are they doing with my shit?
I don't normally wipe your ass, so I can tell you how that would work.
You're not Karate Kid with my asshole.
You know, that should be the name of this episode. You're not Karate Kid in my asshole.
But
no, hold on, if we ever make a Plika T-shirt, that's what we need to have.
Anyway, I don't know. They're weird. Like, they don't fly and have gadgets. They fucking make grass grow on people. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Or they turn fucking into the person. I don't know. It's just not. I just don't get into it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's, some people do. Some, you know, like, obviously, like, what's the Flash guy's name in X-Men? Quicksilver?
Oh, Quicksilver, yeah.
Makes sense. Wolverine. A little weird that he has Freddy Krueger hands, but. At least you know what he's doing. But some of the other ones, I don't know.
I can see that. Some people, it's a little
I just didn't get into it. So, like, only seeing those two, this movie that we watched last night was, and they even had some of those kids had those powers.
Yeah. But it was cool, too, because, like, they were actually different than, like, things you generically see in those movies, you know what I mean?
Yeah. But this movie is really good.
Yeah, I really like. If they made an X-23 movie, would you go see it?
Is that the little girl?
That's the little girl. Yeah.
Yeah, I would.
And they'd either call. I think if they did, they'd either call it that or her comics. Now that's going on is just called the All New Wolverine.
Oh, that sounds like a horrible title.
It kind of is because it's weird. I don't know why they call it that.
What are female Wolverines called?
I don't know. Probably just Wolverine.
Wolvercunts?
Oh my god. But what the movie reminded me of a little bit is in All New Wolverine, I've only read the second book of it, volume 2 of it,
mm-hmm.
because Ultimate Logan was in it. But the girl Wolverine, Laura, she has a clone, and I think her name's Gabby or Gabrielle, something like that.
I'm not a big fan of clones either. Attack of the Clones, none of that shit.
See, I think it's kind of cool with them because they kind of make a family. But there's a clone of her, so like she actually has a little girl that she's with. So, like, that kind of reminded me of, which, spoilers for that storyline, and when Old Man Logan comes back, he keeps having these visions, because in his world, like...
Are you spoiling a comic book right now?
Yeah. Uh-oh. In his world where he came from, because he accidentally came from a different universe, I'd very vaguely explained it, Uh-oh. And how he got into, like, the Marvel Universe now, and he's in, like, every book now. The clone of Laura started like they don't know if she was evil, but she started killing people. So he wanted to stop her,
evil.
And he was gonna fight her. And the part of the storyline, he ends up killing her and holding her up in the air, and like he kills a little girl after he keeps like kind of builds a relationship with them.
Wait, I have a question.
What?
When he lifted her up in the air, did he wave her like she just don't care?
No, he actually got shot at a bunch, and the other Wolverine girl was gonna fight her. But what I liked is like Laura got that little girl like a little Wolverine, so she had like a little pet Wolverine.
Oh my.
But like their relationship reminded me of her and the little girls. But let's get back into the actual movie.
And we can do spoilers here, right?
Anyone
that would watch this?
Yeah.
The clone of Wolverine was cool.
I like that too. I watched a review today and they said they loved the movie, but they could have done without that. I think that was really cool because, I mean, everything else in the movie I kind of expected except for Wolverine.
Yeah, I didn't
except for him actually dying in the end. I didn't expect
he
that.
He kind of reminded me of like the Terminator.
That's what they compared it to in that video I watched too. But yeah, it was kind of cool though. Like it was like,
cause
like especially for I can imagine Hugh Jackman. Like for the final movie, he gets to play. He gets to play young Wolverine, R-rated, and an old one too.
Yeah.
And like fight himself. That was really.
He
cool.
He didn't get to talk as one of them, but yeah.
Yeah. That speaking of that was really funny when she finally talks after Patrick Stewart dies. Yeah. She's going off and he's like, "Where the fuck were you 2,000 miles ago, you mute?" And then they start, and then she keeps down and he's like, "Shut up, shut up, shut up, shut the fuck up."
Yeah, that was. I did feel like at the beginning, I said this last night, that like, He was a cranky son of a bitch, don't get me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But I felt like they were like, can you just say fuck one more time in this scene so we can make it rated R? I mean, it's rated R. You can say fuck one more time, like one way or the other. You know what I mean?
It did. I didn't feel like that until the girl flashed him her boobs in the limo. And I was like, all right, come on. You're just doing that because it's rated R. Like, you didn't need that. Like, there was,
I actually
there was
forgot
no point
that.
In that. Like, that was like.
Well, he's a limo driver. That would happen if you're fucking taking around bad
bets. I guess, yeah, but like.
Now, should we talk about the best part of the movie?
The scene beforehand?
Yeah.
Which I saw people talking about today. They might not be able to put that online because of licensing issues because of the music for Deadpool.
Oh, really? I looked it up on YouTube today to see, like, someone had filmed it and was all, like, cockeyed and crooked. And I was like, dude, hold your phone straight.
I don't think they're actually going to be able to put. If they upload it online, then they probably, like, spend a ton of money trying to get the actual rights to the music.
Because
I think technically they don't have to pay for it because they just put it in front of the movie. It's like a teaser. Like, they're not getting. People aren't going to theater just to watch that. They're going to see Logan.
Right.
So I think they got, like, a workaround that way.
Yeah, that was funny.
But yeah, I like that. I kind of hope the Fox makes that their new thing. Instead of post-credit scenes, they just put, like, because it doesn't have to connect to any of the movies. Just, like, have a little scene with a random character. That'd be cool.
Yeah, it's almost like a cartoon in the front of a cartoon.
Yeah, like a thing before, like, a Pixar movie.
Yeah.
Like, because they're still making Gambit. I don't know when, but they're still making that. Like,
no, they're not.
Yeah, they are. They came back out and said that because, like, it was going to get canceled for a while.
No, that's why I was joking.
But, like, just throw a Deadpool scene in front of that, too. Why not? Like, Deadpool and Cable or something.
Just every movie has a thing with Deadpool in front of it?
Yeah,
why not? Star Wars and.
Yeah. Batman v Superman, that make that better.
But that also what made it cool is, I mean, even though we thought there was going to be something about Deadpool in the beginning because you read it.
Yeah.
Which
Stanley wasn't in that.
No, unless he shot the guy. I didn't see who shot
him.
Yeah,
I didn't see, unless it was Stanley in the alley. I didn't see him.
But it was funny, even though you knew it was going to happen, it was still funny.
Wait, because we didn't know what was going to happen.
The thing
I read said Stanley and him have a conversation.
No. What I meant, like, when he goes into the phone booth,
he gets naked,
they show his ass. Like, you knew where it was going, and it was still funny.
It was also really funny, because they played the Superman music the whole time, so he's getting ready, and he's like, da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah.
And, like, he's doing that, he's like, oh.
And also, what's funny about it is that's how long it would take to get dressed in a phone booth.
Yeah, that was really funny, too.
Yeah.
He finally gets it out, he's like, oh, next time I should probably just call the police. And then he just lays on the dead guy's body and starts eating his food.
Yeah, he ate his Ben and Jerry's.
Which
is hard to do when you have a mask on.
Yeah, I was thinking that. He never actually put it in his mouth. He just kind of scooped it out and then stayed there for a second. And
That's what she said.
And as he was fucking talking, and they had words on the screen, this bitch comes in the theater right in front of these guys in front of us. Three girls just in front. Oh, here's your straw. Here's the popcorn. Here's this. And they're like, sit the fuck down.
I don't know what words came up on the screen.
I don't know what he said. It said Deadpool. It didn't say two. And then it said coming not soon enough or whatever. But I didn't see what else came after that, and I didn't get to hear what he was saying.
He was still babbling about stuff.
But I still wanted to hear it.
Yeah. Yeah, they were annoying as fuck.
And it was so weird. I don't know if you noticed it. We talked about it a little bit last night, but the guy right in front of you, like, every 15 minutes, he would grab his hat and just hold it up in the air. Like this. And I like, nudged Taylor. I was like, what is he doing? Because I told her, look at the floating head. Because, like, it looked like the guy had a floating hat, because, like, it looked like he had no
head. I didn't even notice it.
He was just sitting there, and then all of a sudden he just goes, whoop, puts it back down. And then, like, 10 minutes later, he does it again, and Taylor nudged me that time, and I was like, what the fuck is this guy doing?
Do you know what that reminds me of?
What?
That Funhouse video you showed me where he's my lady.
Oh. Yeah, totally.
Maybe he was doing that.
Maybe.
Maybe he was jerking off.
So.
You're just going to remind jerking off comment?
Yeah. Oh. That family got kind of fucked up
Logan.
Like, they took him in, it was all nice and all that.
And then they all died.
Although
he was going to kill Wolverine. Not really, but.
As Professor X starts saying, which apparently he killed all the X-Men, or at least most of them. And
right over my head.
Well,
because they kept saying.
Well, because they said previously on the radio that, like, and a ton of X-Men died and they turned off the thing because of that.
Yeah.
It was right for that casino scene. So I'm assuming that thing, his little seizure thing, just went on too long.
See, and I guess I thought that happened in the previous X-Men movie.
Oh, no, it's never happened before.
Oh, so that was
I think
just,
it was just a thing.
So they just went to the future and then made up the past? Sort of?
Yeah.
Right? Because it was 2029.
Yeah, well, because, like, in the Old Man Logan storyline.
Because,
like,
those semis with no drivers were kind of cool.
Yeah. But, like, because in the
Except for the horses.
In the Old Man Logan comic, Wolverine's the one that killed all the X-Men because I think it's Mysterio. I think that's his name. he tricks Wolverine into thinking he's fighting all the villains. So, like, he's stabbing all these guys and all that. And then he finally comes back to it, and he has his knife, I think, in Jean Grey. And he looks all around, and he killed every single one of the X-Men. So I think it was, like, their way of doing that, but they said they blamed it on Professor X because of his, like, little seizures that were going on.
Right. Which, I mean, yeah, what's the difference? But, yeah, he felt bad for it.
I was hoping that they would have just kept it Hugh Jackman and, like, gave us a flashback like that.
I don't think his ass could have handled killing everybody like that.
Well, it happened 7 years ago, they said. So
no, but what I'm saying is I don't think his character could handle it. I think he would have killed himself, and there would have been no movie. And then now are you happy?
Well, in the Old Man Logan,
now are you happy?
He wanted to.
I know, but he didn't.
At the end, did you see the adamantium bullet thing coming when the little girl shot the guy in the head?
Well, I saw her look for the gun, and I thought, what good that going to do? You're going to shoot him, he's going to...
Because when they first started fighting, and I saw him show up there. Mm-hmm. I nudged, like, oh, they're totally going to shoot him in the head with that adamantium bullet. And Tila goes, oh, yeah, probably.
Well, and then, so I didn't really realize it. I wasn't really thinking about it
mm-hmm.
until, like, she put the bullet in the gun. And I was like, oh, I got it.
It was actually pretty sad when he died. She was sitting there crying.
Oh, I thought you meant
the clone.
I was like, why was that sad?
Well, when Hugh Jackman died?
Yeah, it was kind of sad.
And then she's sitting there crying, and now
I think Taylor cried.
She has no dad.
Has Taylor ever cried in a movie?
I don't think so. I don't think ever in her life. I think she's cried at a show before. No, yeah, remember she cried at that one movie because that guy killed himself. And she me and you were filming that basketball video, and we opened the door, and she's just bawling.
Yeah, but what movie was that?
I don't know. You know one thing Taylor showed me and I almost teared up?
Oh, fuck. A Flash?
No, it was this YouTube. Super. It was Teens React to something, or it was YouTubers React. And this guy videoed, he goes, all right, bud, you had to pull his dog. He goes, it's your last day, so we're going to make it a hell of a day. And he goes to, like, the park with his dog and goes to Carl's Jr., buys a bunch of burgers, and him and his dog are eating burgers at the park and all this stuff. He's just giving the dog whatever he wants for his last day.
And then he kills
the
dog?
And as the video's going on, they go to the pound, and the dog has to get an injection, and the dog dies.
Oh, that's nice.
But I was like, oh, my God. I think the dog was, like, really sick, so he had to do that anyways. But
well, then why did he give him hamburgers?
So he just had to go on with the day and give the dog the best day ever. But, like, I was like, oh, that's really sad. And the guy was, like, videoing there, and he's just petting the dog as it's dead on the floor. It almost made me tear up.
Wow.
Because I was just thinking, oh, when JoJo dies, are you going to give him some burgers?
No.
What? That's fucked up. You would give Phoebe a burger.
That's different.
And you've given her bacon before. I mean, she's not even dying.
I didn't give the pig bacon.
Why'd you look around and see if anyone's going to tell you? She's eaten bacon before.
First of all.
From you.
First of all.
Second of all.
She didn't eat bacon. That's what you said.
Oh, I hate you.
It was turkey bacon.
You've given her normal bacon.
No, I haven't. That's fucked up.
Haven't you given her, like, pork chops?
No, she begged for them all the time, though.
I know. Mauser gave her pepperoni once.
Yeah, but it was an accident at first.
He was begging for it, and he gave her a piece.
Yeah, whatever.
So what was your favorite part about Logan?
Deadpool.
No, really.
It really was. I don't know. The little girl was cool. Yeah. I liked her fighting. And yeah, her little,
I think mine was all the fight scenes, I think.
Yeah, like, the fight scenes with her.
She was, like, jumping them, wrap around their heads, throw them on the floor, and, like, stab them with her
foot
and
really
all that.
I really did like the fight scenes and how graphic they were.
Yeah.
And they weren't over the top, necessarily.
It was just kind of what would really happen if you stabbed a guy with claws.
I mean, theoretically. I've never seen a guy stabbed with claws, so I don't know.
I guess that's true. I did, like, too, because they have part of it in the trailer, but they obviously can't show the guy's head. The part of the trailer when she's walking out of the building and...
when she throws
the backpack, she throws one dude's head at the other guy.
She could look really evil at times.
Yeah. It's funny because sometimes she looked really evil, then sometimes she just looked like an innocent little girl.
Yeah.
I did like, too, how she just took over driving when he passed out in the woods.
Yeah, she's letting me drive.
And she stole
it. And then she just drove.
Yeah.
She stole the car. He's like, you can't just keep stealing shit. And then he just, like, drives away in the car that she stole. So, I mean... Or, in this place, he's like, you can't take what... And then he takes a charger and some cigars. teaching or anything.
That was funny, though.
Yeah.
I really like the movie. Does it make you want to watch the other Wolverine movie? Like, you don't have to watch the X-Men movies. I mean, you don't have to do anything.
Oh, glad I don't have to.
But,
thank God.
But does it make you interested in watching the other Wolverine movie?
I mean, maybe. I mean, I think this was different in my view because it involved like another like this. This didn't even feel like a comic book movie to me.
I can see that. Yeah,
I mean, except
that's what they kind of were going for, more realism. But like, I mean, obviously there's people with powers and shit, but like,
yeah, but like barely. I mean, kinda, yeah. And I guess they were like breeding them, and there was clones and shit. That part was like,
but it didn't feel like it. Yeah,
like no one flew. No, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
no one went back in time.
I wish they did. Then I could see some other people.
No one said Wonder Twins hours. Wonder Twin powers activate.
Fuck. But I think after watching this and we've seen Deadpool and all that, I think certain characters should automatically have to they should have to have a rated R movie. Like, I think Batman movies should be rated R, and like, because like I think if they keep like with Fox, like they keep doing like the solo movies rated R, but then when they team up, keep it PG-13 so everybody can go see it. I think that'd be kind of cool and smart.
Yeah, I mean, it just depends. Like, Superman's not gonna be rated R.
Well, yeah, Superman shouldn't be. Spider-Man shouldn't be.
But Spider-Man should be.
Like Batman, I think that should be rated R. And like,
maybe it depends.
Like, it'd just be cool if certain characters got like rated R movies. That like,
I mean, Blade was rated R.
They should bring back Blade. Easy. I thought there was talks of him getting his own Netflix series, and like he was gonna be the same dude.
Oh, Wesley Snipes?
Yeah, because he was in talks with Marvel, but then I think all those just fell through.
He probably needs the money, too.
Probably, yeah. I know there was talks, too, of, like, I think his daughter. Did he have a daughter? I'm pretty sure there was talks of his daughter or, like, maybe a son. I don't know. Something like that, playing Blade.
Oh, I don't know about his family.
But, yeah, I don't know. I think it'd be a lot cooler if, like, because, like, some of the characters don't need a rated R movie, but I think it'd be cool if some of them did.
Right.
Other than Fox movies. Because, like, can you imagine, like, a Ben Affleck R-rated Batman movie? Maybe like Gone Girl, we see his penis again.
Kevin Smith and Jason Mewes are in it.
That'd be cool, yeah. That'd never happen. Not a million years.
They're like out by the quick stop.
Like this would be crazy and probably a little stupid, but imagine like a rated R Flash movie. He's just like phasing through. Like imagine Reverse Flash, like blood splattering all over the wall.
Oh, I get you.
Gorilla Grodd's like actually ripping dudes' heads off with his teeth.
Yeah, that'd be kind of cool, but like. To a degree, you don't need
and
that.
And then Flash could be like, you killed my mom, you motherfucker.
See, that would be fake.
That'd be you don't think Flash would say that?
No. And then, like, I don't feel like...
Like, imagine Cisco would curse all the time.
Yeah, probably.
I can see Cisco as a big cursor. And I don't mean, like, on a computer screen.
Just a big arrow on the...
Oh, my God. An arrow! That'd be a cool radar movie.
Yeah. Yeah, that might be cool. Except that it'd be... Like, it would have to be him. Like, I don't want to see some other dude.
What if it was Matt Damon?
He's too short.
Or Keanu Reeves.
Too short? No, I don't know.
I think that'd be kind of cool, one of them as hero.
You should make John Wick
on Kevin Smith's show, Geeking Out, when it was on AMC,
mm-hmm.
I almost said Matt Smith. Matt Damon said that he would like to play Arrow, and that he likes the Arrow comics and all that.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I could see him.
Oh, I think you showed me that, actually.
That'd be cool. Him, Arrow, and then Ben Affleck's. Batman? That'd be pretty sweet.
Batman and Arrow would not get along.
Well, they're like the same person, so maybe they would.
That's why they wouldn't get along.
You don't think the two of the same people
get along? How come Arrow doesn't have a Robin?
He does. Like, coming up. Season 2. It's not Robin, but it's Red Arrow.
Oh, that's stupid.
And then he has his sister, Speedy.
Whatever.
And then he has the next following season.
All she's done since I watched is crash a car into a bridge, and she didn't even care.
Oh, my God.
Didn't she?
Yeah, but you're such a dildo.
Well, she didn't care.
Anything else you want to say about Logan?
I'm
ignoring you again.
About Logan. No, not really.
Do you recommend people to go see it?
Oh, yeah, it was cool.
Yeah, I definitely recommend going and seeing it. What would you give it on a scale of 1 to 10?
Oh, probably like an 8.
I think I'd give it 8 or a 9, yeah.
Yeah.
This is my original question. Compared to all the other comic book movies that have been out, like, where would you put this in, like, your top 10 list?
I don't know.
Where's Deadpool on that list? Is that number 1?
Yeah, probably. But, I mean, I'm biased to Deadpool, so... But, like, we talked about this yesterday before we saw the movie.
Yeah.
I like Civil War a lot.
Yeah, I think Civil War is probably my top movie.
Civil War rated R would be kind of cool, too.
That would have been, yeah.
I like Ant-Man. I don't know why.
I don't know. Ant-Man was really good. I think it's mostly Paul Rudd. Like, I think if it was someone else, I probably wouldn't have liked it as much. Yeah, no, I think
it's like 95% Paul Rudd. I think you're right.
Or as I tried to call him yesterday, Raw Pud.
Yeah. Which is completely different. It's probably in the top 10. I don't know. I don't think it's the top 5. Maybe. I don't know. It's hard because we just saw it.
Yeah. Oh, I want to buy it when it comes out on Blu-ray, obviously. But then I just saw the director's set, which is kind of like that Mad Max thing, which I wish I would have waited for, even though they came out with it like a year later. They're going to do the black and chrome version of Logan also on Blu-ray.
What does that mean?
So it's like black and white, but like the whites are like a little more shiny, and like they re-edited the movie basically black and white, but like it looks a little nicer.
Oh, really?
And like certain colors will be like, it'll look different. I want the Mad Max version, but I don't want to spend $30 on it because I already own it on Blu-ray. So I'm waiting for it to get real cheap so I could buy it. Because I feel like it's stupid to buy the same movie twice for more money when I already own half of what I'm buying.
And when's the last time you watched it?
A couple months ago. So if I bought that, I'd watch it again because it would look different. But that's why I don't want to spend $30 to watch the same movie over again.
You could trade in the Blu-ray for the...
I didn't think about that. I probably could do that, yeah.
At least you'd get something for it.
That's true. Maybe I should just do that. God, you're smarter than me, you know that?
You're so stupid.
I never thought about that. I go to ZS every fucking week, a place where you trade in stuff, and I was like, I want that movie, but I already own it. And I was like, oh, well, I'm going to own two copies of it eventually. Well, why not just trade it in?
You know what? I can't answer that.
Can't believe I never thought of that. I feel real stupid now.
Wow. Maybe this should be the end of the podcast. So yeah. You could think about stuff.
Yes, that's the end of the podcast. Any final things you want to say about any of the shows we watched this week or Logan and you being a little horse?
I'm not a little horse.
What'd you say?
I fixed it.
What'd you say, Mr. Miyagi on your asshole?
I said, don't karate kid my asshole.
Don't karate kid my asshole.
Yeah.
I think that might be the name of this podcast.
I don't even know what that means.
Me either, but that's...
Well, because it's like wax on, wax off.
Say you're scrolling through YouTube and you're like, don't karate kid my asshole, the Plika podcast. And then you see
I'm not clicking that.
You wouldn't click that?
No.
I'd be like, what the fuck does that mean? And I'd have to click it, I think.
And then they have to watch 50 minutes of it to fucking realize what it says.
Maybe I'll put a time... Oh! It's the end of the podcast now, but maybe... You know what? I'm going to cut this and I'll put it in the beginning of the podcast. So welcome to the beginning of the podcast, people.
Oh my God.
I've been wanting to say
so
this
stupid.
For weeks. And I've been...
You're dumb.
I've been fucking forgetting every time. So, in this podcast, any of the topics we talk about...
Like Karate Kid's asshole?
So this will be the podcast twice because I'm putting it in the beginning and I'll leave it in the normal spot too.
Oh, that's
maybe
tricky.
I don't know. We'll figure it out. Anyways.
That's like an episode of Flash going back in time.
Anyways... Any of the topics we talk about, I have time coded in the description. So, like, say you're like, I came here just to hear them talk about Logan. I don't give a shit about Flash. I don't give a shit about Supergirl.
Nobody gives a shit about Supergirl.
Taboo. Any of that shit. I just want to hear them talk about Logan. Say we talked about it 20 minutes in. You just go to the description, you just click on the 20 minutes in button, and then you're there to that part of the podcast. I've been meaning to tell people that so they can get to the certain topics they want to in the podcast.
I bet a lot of people already know that, though.
Maybe. If you look in the descriptions and all the videos you watch, then I guess you would know that.
Yeah.
But I feel like I should still tell people in case they don't. Now you know.
And da, na, na, na. What the fuck was that?
You know, the Now You Know music.
No.
Anyways, so that's it. Now you know. Thanks for watching the Plika podcast, everybody. Actually, before I actually end it, should I put that in the beginning or should I leave it in the end?
I don't care. Whatever you think.
We'll figure it out.
Wait, put it in the beginning so people will know.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for listening to the Plika podcast, everybody. We'll be back next week with Flash, Supergirl.
Not Taboo.
Not Taboo. That's over. And I think Kong.
I think Kong.
I think we'll be talking about Kong next week, but, you know, don't hold us to it.
I think Kong.
Shut the fuck up. Oh, you know what we could do? Oh, I do have a Kong pop figure, so I can have that here. But we could also get those
Why
Kong.
Why didn't you put Gorilla Grodd up here?
Because I'm stupid. I had that last week. I didn't do it this week. But we could put King Kong up here. And we could put Godzilla, too, because he's connected to the movie. Rumor he's in a cameo in it. I could get one of those Kong dog toys.
You could have had Grodd and King Kong and pretend they were the two gorillas fighting.
Yeah, I didn't think about it.
Except
know,
for the airport.
Where were you when I was fucking setting up everything?
I was taking your fucking sister to work.
My fucking sister? Why'd you say it like that?
I don't know. That's how I say fucking sister.
You said that a lot. You know, I just thought about it again. This is like the fourth week in the world. Fourth week in a row that we've talked about fucking sisters. And not just now. We talked about earlier Tom Hardy fucking his sister.
Well, because we've been talking about Taboo and he's fucking his sister.
Before you talked
about... Did you just say E-I-E-I-O?
No. Okay. Before that, you talked about Wally West fucking Iris. You said he phased in his sister's vagina or something.
No, I did not.
Yeah, you did.
You're making shit up.
Well, whatever. Thanks for listening to the podcast, everybody. Like I said, we'll be back next week with maybe Kong.
I'm not sure what you just said.
Hopefully they did. All right, you can listen to this podcast. You can watch this podcast on YouTube. Listen to it on Stitcher, Spreaker, iTunes. Goodbye.
That's it? After all that?
I ended it like three times now. People just want this to be over.
Yeah, me too.
Ooh-wee! Good afternoon!